lessons, Mark and friends, it's not to focus on what's important yet again. So priorities in my school. Here's our learning, teaching and learning policy. It's a one-page summary. Behind it will be the detail. Now, already this detail is 20 pages long, and I know no one's going to read it. So I've got to make it concise. I've got to cut the waffle out and go straight to the point. So we've moved to Google. We're a Google school, and it's superb for workload. There's no more saving version 12, version 13, version 14 of different documents. As you work, it's there online, it's live. And the first week of us using that in September, you can see staff start to collaborate on the same presentation, the kids too. It's just superb. So if you're not using Google, I would highly advocate it for you. You can see on this document, you haven't got it on your sheet of paper, but the blue hyperlinks lead to information behind, so examples of or photos of and things like that. And we hope the one-page summary will be in fashion displays, it will be in our teacher planners, and the staff will know it, not our students necessarily, but our staff. And again, I want to emphasise that we don't want everyone to do the same model, we want to have some consistency to help raise standards. We introduced an MER cycle, it was unknown in the school, but more importantly, to study the workflow and the workload, so staff knew what would come in terms of trying to improve the things that we did. So that's on my blog if you want to grab a copy. But in terms of Mark, here's the first section of the Mark policy. Secure overview, teachers knowing their data inside out, okay, the student progress. Formative, so we introduced the yellow box. Again, it doesn't have to be yellow. It's just a mechanism for direct feedback in student books. And it allows the teachers, I'll show you some examples, it allows the teachers just to focus on one aspect of the work rather than marking everything. Marking should be regular. Before we edited this, it said 6 and 12 and all different numbers if you're an art teacher versus a maths teacher, because you're sure the students at different lengths of time. So we just changed it. Regular, that's it. If marking's not happening, then it's not regular. How you define that is up to the curriculum. It's proportionate to the curriculum time. And then the marking code. Now, on a recent work sample, which I'll show you, we found that the marking code's still developing. And again, we're not going to beat teachers over the stick. We want teachers to mark books, but more importantly, we want students to act in the feedback that they receive. So, a reminder about marking. Active feedback, we know if it's meaningful, sophisticated, it can aid progress significantly. And Mary Myatt, brilliant. High quality, not truckloads of ticks, fewer things done really well. I only looked at books a couple of weeks ago, a new marking policy, and still I've got teachers just ticking, 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 absolutely wasting their time and no value to the student whatsoever. So it's just best not to do it. Ofsted does not expect to see a frequency. Ofsted does not expect unnecessary written dialogue. I've written about verbal feedback stamps. They might work for you. My opinion, I don't think they work. Verbal feedback should be verbal. You shouldn't be stamping books to prove something for someone else. Okay?